Chris here with another solar generator. This is from a company called Jackery, the first time I've tested out their products, and it is their Explorer 1500 Pro. So the capacity of this particular model here is 1512 watt hours, and it can supercharge in just 2 hours via AC, so you just plug it in and you can have it rapid charge in 2 hours, and via solar too as well, if you have six of these, which I've got in front of me. This is the SolarSaga. It's a 200 watt portable solar panel that's got magnets in it, and it all folds up and you can use it to charge the solar station right here. So the peak output of this particular model is 1800 watts from the two AC ports, and we have two power delivery Type-C ports that do support 100 watt charging or 100 watt output from it too as well. Now the solar station is also very quiet compared to some of the others I have tested out. It's around about 46 decibels, really quiet compared to the competitors out there, and it does have a built-in battery monitoring system. So it's got 8 sensors in there to make sure that it's not gonna overheat, overcharge, or over-discharge. There's a lot of safety built into such a unit like this. And inside the box, you will find this. It's the user manual for the Explorer 1500 Pro, a black pouch. And within this pouch here, we get two DC input adapters and then two cables. So one is our AC cable for charging. Then we have a DC cigarette lighter charging cable. So there are ample uses for a solar station such as this. Right now, I'm using the solar panel here to charge the battery bank within the solar station, which is then in turn charging the batteries for the e-bikes that I do review in my channel. And of course, you can use this for camping. It's going to be perfect for that emergency use. And it is portable and relatively lightweight for this style of solar station. It is about 16, just over 16 kilos or around 37 pounds, which compared to the competitors and its capacity is a fairly decent weight. And another question that often does pop up is just how long is this going to last for? Well, if you only use it once a week, it'll go for 20 years, is Jackery's claim. And if you cycle it 2,000 times, well, the battery capacity, those cells will then be down to 70%, which is very impressive considering that's a full discharge and recharge 2,000 times, and it's still gonna have 70% capacity of that 15,012 milliamp hours. So taking a look at the output side of things here and the display. So the display here is a color display. You can see it quite clearly. Now it's shimmering, but that's just on camera to do with my shutter rate. And you can see information like, for example, your voltage here for the output, the hertz, the current output, the amount of time remaining, and our percentage of the battery, and then the input. It also will detect those solar panels when you do plug them in. So we've got buttons for all of the set parts here. So this is our DC, so 12 volts, 10 amps out here with our car accessory or the lighter port here. So turning that on, it goes on straight away. When you press it, it goes off straight away. Unlike other brands, you have to press and hold and you have to wait some time. That doesn't happen here with this Jackery, which is really good. Now the display will automatically time out to save on, of course, the battery. And just under this little protective flap here, you'll find a light and it's very bright. So again, this is great for emergency use. If you tap it again, it's even brighter. And then we do have the SOS that's gonna keep firing that off too as well. So again, great for emergency situations. So the little covers, rubber caps that go over them just to keep the dust and things out and to protect it, that is actually quite a good idea. And doing this on camera, there we go, it's set in place. Then we've got USB type A ports here. There's two of them. These are 18 watts max. And we've got Qualcomm's Quick Charge 3.0 support with these. And then USB type Cs. There are two of them here and they're 100 watts max, which is great, supporting power delivery. And you turn that on, you can see it's instant on and off. And then on this side here, because I do have the EU version, of course I've got EU plugs, we get two of them here, and we've got 1800 watts maximum output from both of these AC plugs, which is great. And again, you can simply just turn that on and off pressing the button right there. It has a little status LED built into it. The overall build quality is excellent. The plastics they have used, great. And here on the left, you can see we've got a vent. Now there's some fans in here. It's got active cooling, of course. And we've got a output noise of around about 42 to 46 decibels when it's under full load. And that's not bad at all compared to the competitors out there. Now there's a lot of protection built into this. So it has a battery monitoring system within there, of course, and it does have 8 sensors to make sure everything's all fine, that it's not going to overvolt, it's not going to overheat or anything. If that does happen, if it goes over the wattage, it will just simply cut out for security. The same with the charging too, so there is overcharging protection and a lot built into that, just to ensure, of course, that it is safe. And on the right, there is another vent, and I can see, just looking through these gaps here, quite a large heat sink in there, keeping all those components cool. And now on the back of it here, we do have our input. So DC input, this is where you plug in your solar panels, for example, and this is the wall charging. Now, if you're using DC input and you happen to use a lot of their panels, and you can use 6 of them in total to get the 2-hour solar charging, or just from the wall socket, you plug that straight in, it will take 2 hours. So that's the super quick charging there. For the capacity that it's rated at, which of course is 1512 watt hours, that's a very good speed, really quick compared to some of the other models that I have been covering. I will just quickly show you this too, because it covers all of the DC input range there. So if you need this information, it's also on their website, of course. But just pause the video, you can take a look at this, because there's a lot of information too, and then you can see all of the outputs there and the ranges. So they do claim that it's 1800 watts, of course it's rated to the AC outputs, but it can surge at 3600 watts. Jackery did miss an opportunity here, I believe, on the top to put some of those wireless charging pads. They could have had 2 either side, even if it was just 15 watts, maybe 20 or 30. Would have been great, and that's one area of criticism from me, is they've missed an opportunity with that there. Now, the handle feels really good, so just like the rest of the build of it, high quality plastics. There is a bit of rubber here for grip, and as I mentioned before, the weight of this particular battery station is about 16 kilos or 37 pounds. And they also sent this out to me, which is their portable solar panel. It's called the SolarSaga 200. Now, it's 200 watts. It does have an IP67 water resistance to it, splash rating, so it can get wet, it can be rained upon, it's not going to be a problem, it's waterproof. And the voltage of this is up to 18 volts, and it does have a 25% efficiency conversion rate, which is quite high for solar panels like this. Now, the panel comes in this zip-up protective case. We have here a user guide and then our cable for this solar panel. As you can see, the panel is very compact, and it does have this handhold here. The build quality is excellent of this panel. It has surprised me. It's very well made, and it does have these legs at the back of it to hold the panel up at the correct angle to get the maximum efficiency for the sunlight, of course. And then to set it up, you just need to open it up like so. It's easier to spread it out first on the ground, and then just simply lift this up and then set up those legs. So those extend outwards at the back. There are 3 of them in total. And now the panel is more or less set up there. And I'll check out what kind of wattage this 200 watt panel can generate on a day like this for me. So our connector is just located here at the top, and you can't get it wrong because it's the only style of plug that's going to fit into that. So I'll just simply put that in the top here now. We'll check that output. So it's telling me it's currently charging at 164 watts, and it has 1.9 hours left to charge the remaining 15%. Not bad considering the day. I'm not in summer yet. Now, the setup I have here is just temporary with this solar panel. It's only to test out these power stations that I do receive, and I love to test them out. So I should be able to get, I would say maybe hopefully around 380, which is the maximum I have seen this panel what it's been able to achieve. But that's been on a perfect day, and it is a little bit hazy. Unfortunately, Jackery do not include the cables that you need, or the cable for the solar connection. Now, I did manage to get one off Amazon, and it was quite cheap. I think it was about 10 or 15 euros. This is a standard cable here, and I can use the adapter that they have included for DC in there. So you can see it's just using the standard solar connector cables for your typical solar panels. So this is looking pretty good for a day like this, 320 watts peak that I'm getting at the moment. And that's gonna take about 3.2 hours, as I showed you before. Really good to have this information so I know when it's gonna be fully charged. I actually started out at about 23%, and it's already gotten up to 31, which isn't bad. Now, if it was a perfectly clear day, this panel could do probably about 380 watts here. Now, if the grid power was completely off, imagine there's huge power cuts and you don't have any solar panels, but your car has still petrol or diesel in it or whatever, then you can use the accessory connection here with the cable that they do supply, which is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to see at what kind of charge rate will we get, what kind of wattage. Even though it's slow, it is at least an option we do have to charge up this battery station. Okay, so it is charging at about 103 watts and it's going to take an hour to gain 5%. So you can see, at least at the output from my socket here, it is very slow, but it's one option we do have in emergencies really. Or if you're on a really long trip and you didn't mind it taking so long, you could plug it in and you'd gain some charge. So we'll see how it does work here then, the Explorer 1500 Pro. And of course, the great thing about this is no emissions. It's not a noisy generator or anything either. And as mentioned, perfect for power tools like this. Load test now, which I've done with other battery stations, solar stations. So what I've got here are some appliances that are well over the 1800 watts that it can do normally. Now it will peak at 3600 watts, but I want to find out for how long, because this hairdryer here and the kettle that I'll put on now, it will peak well over 2000, about 2200. So I'll turn it on now and we'll see how long it will hold the load for. So there we go, it's pulling 2,200 watts at the moment, still hasn't cut out. It continues on, remember it's only 1,800 watts. I can hear it starting to boil that water now. And it's telling me that it's only gonna work for about 0.6 hours at this current power draw from it, which is pretty normal, very demanding. And it hasn't cut out yet, but as soon as I start this hairdryer, I'll start it on the low setting, it'll probably cut out. There we go, it has. Okay, so it just cut out with that. But that's good, it looks like we will be able to boil water at least. And if you're using about 2000, so slightly over the 1800 watts, it will be fine. Now this will of course reset itself and I'll have to turn everything off and then back on again. And now this should work. It might need a little bit of a cool down period. I might have to power it all off first and then I'll try again. Okay, I did hear it just tick over and now everything is working, just to show you. Pulling over 2,100 watts there, not a problem again. So it's great to see that the safety's gonna work. It pulls too much, it will trip out of course, and you just have to unplug things, power it off, power it back on again, and it will work. Now a test of the charge and discharge at the same time. So it's currently charging at just over 700 watts. Outputting only 100 watts at the moment, but I will turn on again the kettle to boil some water. So this is really putting it under a lot of stress here. So we're going over the 1800 watts. It's pulling just over that. So it's almost 1900 watts. And the input charge rate has dropped down. And I can hear the fan a little bit, but it is quiet. Now I'm starting to hear the kettle boil, of course. And the Type-C ports are charging just fine. So I have a laptop here with Type-C charging, a modern phone also charging with that, no problems. And I've tested out the Type-A ports with the Qualcomm's Quick Charge 3 also working. So everything works fine on here. And I'm happy about that, of course, that it works as they have intended and even better, because I didn't expect it to last as long going over 1800 watts as it has in my tests. Other brands, they just cut out straight away. Then the fan noise and the heat. You can feel a bit of warm air coming out of it. That's normal because there's heat sinks in there. It's cooling down the components. We want this, of course. And the fan noise, yes, you will hear it, but I will say this, it is quieter than other models I have reviewed. So here's a sample of the fan when it's under load. So overall, I do like this Explorer 1500 Pro compared to the Blue T and the EcoFlow units of similar capacities that I have reviewed. This has a very good build quality to it. I like how quick it just powers on and the screen gives you that very simple, clear information of how long the battery will last approximately or how long it will take to charge. And this is something that other models don't have. It's just starting to come in and we're seeing more of it. And this model here, the best thing too with it is how quiet it is. Like right now I've got it charging and it's charging at almost 400 watts. It's very quiet, and even with my discharge tests, you hear the fan a little bit, but it's nothing like, again, those competitors out there. To me, this Jackery is better than those similar branded products from Blue Tea, from EcoFlow. Jackery here gets a big thumbs up from me, the build quality. Now, if there was anything I would add to this model here, or could say that was missing, that would be they've missed an opportunity here with the top of it. So the top, there is nothing here. They could have put a couple of your Qi standard wireless chargers on the top of this. Would have been nice. I know we do have, of course, we've got the power delivery support, 100 watts of Type-C ports, but a couple of wireless chargers on the top in case you didn't have those cables would come in handy. And it would have been nice to have maybe another AC output on this of 1800 watts. That's really it. Apart from that, this is a fantastic, outstanding power station, solar power station from Jackery, their Explorer 1500 Pro.